You're listening to the 6 in 60 podcast, episode 15. So congratulations for downloading a truly independent, for the people, by two people podcast. I'm, of course, your host, Charlie Rivera, joined, as always, by Gerard Nolan. What you're hearing in the background is B.B. King's Ghetto Woman, one of my personal favorite B.B. King's songs. And he, of course, is a topic this week, along with Comic-Con, the New York Rangers hockey team, flirting and not doing it so well, drinking way too much and doing it very well, teachers gone wild. And trust me, I know a teacher. She's boring as shit. So when teachers go wild, woo, do they seem like a lot of fun. Guys, 6060.net is where you find all of our podcasts, this episode and 14 others. It's where you find completely free podcasting and the way that we podcast for free, because I certainly need a little taste. I need a little something in my pocket, is our lovely sponsors. This week's episode is brought to you by Atomic Comics, located at 895 D. Monzok Highway, Shore, New York, 11967. They're located again at 895 D. Monzok Highway in Shore, New York, 11967. They are, in my opinion, the greatest comic book store in the universe. Not because they have tons of everything, but because of Mac, the owner. He knows what you want to read. Tell him shit you like, he'll give you a couple more things. That's called being a good salesman. But also, he bats about 950 out of 1,000. Every now and then, he'll give me some. I'm just not fucking smart enough to enjoy. But for the most part, he will get you guys reading the right shit, not just the obvious shit. Speaking of the right stuff, our other sponsor is ReadUSComics.com, a brand new comic book company that will be launching later this year. The best thing you can do, go to the website right now, www.readuscomics.com, and save that sumbitch, because it's going to be where you hear all about the comic book moving forward. And you can join them and us on Facebook, facebook.com/6and60, as well as facebook.com/readuscomics for all sorts of major announcements. But with all that shit out of the way, again, thank you for tuning in. This is Charlie Rivera telling you to enjoy 60 minutes of podcast goodness. Let's take it away, me and Gerard from the past. Yes, Comic-Con! We are going to Comic-Con.
So fucking we're going to Comic-Con.
That joke hasn't taken off. No one likes it but you.
Hold on.
You're the
hold
only
on. You
so
that?
Fucking.
That's me beating a dead horse.
Beating a head. The worst part is, on some episodes, it's every segment you do the joke.
Oh, yeah.
Because in real life, it's every segment.
So fucking.
I had to, like, cut some out last week. I was like, no. Too many sofas.
You know what? I was listening. I was like,
too many sofas are having sex.
I heard that. I was listening to last week, so I'm like, I feel like I said a lot more so fucking.
You did. Trust me. Trust me,
bitch.
You did. New York Comic Con. Last year, I believe it officially became larger in attendees than San Diego Comic Con. Obviously, still has more of a lean towards comic books, but the entertainment aspect.
It's attendites.
Picking up fucking huge. Attendites?
Yeah.
The attendites of Comic Con!
Of San Diego.
San Diego.
Whale's vagina. Anyway.
Fair enough. Are you a little closer to the mic?
So it beat a little closer?
Yeah. Terrible.
So it beat
last
out
year, I believe so. Again, yeah. I'm fucking taking a wild guess because I remember reading that. This year was fucking bananas, though. Here's what happened for those of you that are listening. You're like, I have listened to this podcast for fucking 14 weeks at this point. What the shit is your podunk podcast doing there? And I'll tell you exactly what happened. So I'm talking to a colleague from work.
Yeah.
She runs our mail. She kind of runs around the office. It's very much like in every movie you've ever
seen.
She's
a mail lady.
It's like a mail clerk, kind of. But she has more responsibilities than that. But part of it is kind of dropping off these packages and whatnot.
Yeah.
So we're talking to her, and she's telling me how she just went to Wizard World a couple weeks ago from when you're listening to this. And I was like, oh, that's so fucking awesome. And in the back of my head, I'm like, what the fuck? You definitely make less money than me. How can you afford to go?
I heard that's one of the more expensive ones.
I don't verbalize it. It's reasonable. I feel like all of them are relatively reasonable, but still, like $40 a day.
Actually, speaking of cons and prices, real quick, I was going to go to Steampunk World's Fair, and that's basically a big festival for steampunk and convention, and they have a shitload of steampunk bands and blah, blah, blah. Guess how much one ticket, like the Saturday pass, was?
$90.
Close. $80.
Jesus Christ.
Isn't that more than Comic-Con?
I mean, it's also more of a niche thing. So
I've been to one, and a couple of years ago I went to Steampunk World's Fair, and one and done. That was good enough for me. With Comic-Con, you get a little bit more variety. With the Steampunk World's Fair, it was just steampunk things and vendors and maybe a little goth and steampunk bands. And when my friend told me it was $80 just for a Saturday pass, one day, that's a little steep.
That's always the most
expensive
day,
too. You know, it's very confined to like one or maybe three genres, and that's it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's peculiar. I always find that stuff weird. And again, it's like it's expensive to be a nerd because that's you're going to spend way more once you get there. So I'm thinking to myself, I'm like, how the fuck is this broad and her husband affording this? Because in my head, I'm like, even if it's
obviously
bucks a day,
he shits gold bars.
He works with me, too.
All right, then.
Also gets paid less than me.
Okay.
Just because he's newer. Unless he fucking really had a way of convincing. Unless he has naked pictures of the person who owns the company. But regardless. So where I'm like kind of nodding at her. She's telling me a story in a long form.
Mm-hmm.
It was a little boring. She's a very sweet girl. But again, it's
boring.
It's just like, get to the fucking end. I got work to do. So I'm thinking to myself, I'm like, well, this is crazy. And then she says something. She's like, well, you know that I get a press pass because I write for Ain't It Cool News. And I was like, oh, yeah, I've checked out a couple of your articles, which I have. She's very good. But as she left, I was like, the fuck? Anyone can write for that website. That's not, it's a fucking forum. What are you talking about? It's like I put my ass on my seat and I set up microphones and shit.
Yeah.
And I got an iPod where I have my little notes I take and my countdown clock so my segments don't run over. Fucking, are you kidding me? So I applied a couple weeks before tickets went officially on sale. And fucking sure enough, they were like, yeah, this counts. Which I was stoked about. So me, myself, Gerard Nolan, my fantastic co-host.
Yeah. Well, I'm not affiliated with you.
No hipster mustache. No hipster mustache. That went away. But he is smoking a vaporizer, and it's high tech now. It no longer looks convenient to carry. It's like a fucking rectangular box.
Actually, it's very convenient
right now.
It looks
like a fucking explosive device.
It is.
In the
the
A-team
don't piss me
would
off.
Be caught somewhere, and that would be the thing with the little switch to set off the dynamite. But it's a little bit divine intervention because Comic-Con, which is October 8th through 11th, and again, 6 and 60 will be there right here in the Javits Center. They had to release a statement about New York Comic-Con. They did this the day of. A few hours after they sold, and I quote.
But why did they do that?
I think it would be better if we just let them.
Oh, it is explained in there.
Exactly.
Okay.
Right.
Didn't know if a lot of people know.
No worries, and they're gonna know in 2 seconds. But I like the way your brain goes.
Dead to me.
Dear New York Comic Con fans, on Wednesday at noon Eastern Time, we put up tickets for the 10th annual edition. Only 10 fucking years. I can't believe it. Of New York Comic Con on sale, and after months of preparation and close working sessions with our ticketing vendor, we almost immediately saw something wasn't right. I know you saw it too. This letter is an attempt to help you understand what happened. And while that still might not get you the tickets to New York Comic Con that you wanted, except for Charlie and Gerard, because we're fucking super awesome, we hope it'll at least provide you with some portion of the explanation that you deserve. Some facts we've been able to ascertain by looking at the data. The demand for tickets at noon was roughly quadruple what they experienced in 2014, their record-breaking year. Those who were attempting to buy tickets in the queue know that it took several hours to move through the queue and received error messages along the way. This was a direct effect of the unexpected and unforeseen slowdown of the system. What's important to note that regardless of the slowdown and error activity, when the queue opened at noon, there were already more individuals in line. Then there were VIP 3-day and 4-day and Saturday tickets can fucking bind. This means that beginning at 12:01, demand outstripped the supply of tickets.
Demand exceeded supply.
Exactly correct. Thus, even without the challenges that they experienced, unexpectedly, no doubt, there was not a guarantee that people in line at 12:01 would receive the exact ticket types they so craved. The queue slowdown lasted until about 3 p.m. At that time, most fans that remained in the queue or refreshed after getting error messages were were able to buy whatever tickets they wanted, keeping in mind of what remained. So now, the real fucking issue, and they get into it here, and then I do want to briefly discuss it with you, Rabbit.
Okay.
Let's talk about those ticket resellers. We don't like them either. We know you see tickets available on reseller sites, and we know how frustrating that is, especially if you didn't get the ticket you wanted. And please know that we continue to be aggressive about doing all that we can to deal with those resellers. We further limited quantities this year. We'll comb through those sites and attempt to get tickets removed. We review the data of each ticket purchaser and cross-check names, addresses, email, credit cards, and then remove and ban where we find people trying to buy tickets over the maximum allowed. In short, we are as frustrated as people by people selling tickets at an inflated price as you are. What can we do about those reselling tickets at inflated prices? Don't buy them. First of all, it creates a market for people to price gouge. But just as important, we'll be canceling as many of those people as we can identify as ticket resellers, meaning those trying to cheat the system by buying large quantities. So you may be buying a worthless piece of paper. Now, I'm thoroughly impressed at New York Comic Con being so aggressive.
Yeah.
How fucking long have we been beholden to these fucking
flippers?
Exactly right. It's you and I talk about it a lot in everything. Vinyl pops, mm-hmm. collectibles, comics, action figures. Mm-hmm. There is a time where I've always deemed it acceptable or appropriate. If something naturally sells out, or if you're late to the party mm-hmm. and you want to get it months and months later, well, too bad, so sad. Mm-hmm. They made 500 sold to real yeah. customers, people who want to take them out and assemble them or display them. That's a real person to me. I fucking have no respect for these people that are going to make fast cash
yeah.
doing literally nothing. It makes me so fucking equal parts mortified yeah. and stoked when I watch a baseball game or a football game mm-hmm. or a hockey game that's sold out
yeah.
and half fucking empty.
See, what what annoys me is that, like, I experienced it a couple months ago was when this Zelda 3DS came out.
Yeah,
was,
we talked about people, it in detail last week.
There was no limit on GameStop and other retailers like Best Buy and whatnot, and these people bought a shit ton of them, and it was a $200 machine. They priced it up to about $500, knowing that it's Zelda, it's limited editions, Nintendo, that stuff always. But, like, to do that right away, I understand if, like, you maybe buy, like, two, hold on to it a couple of years, it's a very limited thing. Yeah.
Even then, I understand why it happens.
If someone's willing to pay $500, is it really worth that much?
Well, no, but it all comes down to, you have to keep in mind, man, for some people, they were able to get their kids tickets and not themselves tickets. Now they've thrown away money, yeah. so they have to pay for these inflated prices.
It sucks.
It fucking just blows, man.
If I'm willing to buy, if there's something that I really want, like a fucking 1 in 1,000 Batman comic, and it's fucking four times the price, but it's been out for years, it's tough to get. If I'm diehard, then maybe. But, like, the people who will go into something like Comic-Con or pre-orders for a video game system and buy a shit ton and take away from fans, because I'm the type of person, if I see something limited that's $10 that I know will go up in, a huge fucking, price in the next couple of days or weeks or whatever, I kind of just buy one for myself. As long as I get one for me, I'm happy. I really don't want to take away from other people, like the Walgreens pops that came out a couple months ago.
Yeah.
I saw, one of each. I grabbed them for myself. I then saw extras. I asked, hey, Charlie, what are you missing? Hey, Wayne, what are you missing? I grabbed one, and that was it. I grabbed you guys.
Yeah,
I got you guys covered. And then I went home. I didn't buy everything. And then sell it for an inflated price.
And
I don't like doing
just
that.
It's just fucking a scumbaggy thing when it is a quantifiable
amount.
It's
scalping tickets outside of a concert.
Exactly
I fucking
right.
can't
it
stand
blows,
that.
Dude. It's one thing if you can't go to the concert and you fucking sell your tickets.
Yeah.
And I'm not even against if you want to
make a couple of dollars,
make
it's
a
fine.
Couple bucks.
Not 100%
for the most part,
profit.
Though, even that I don't like. My friend has season tickets to the Rangers.
Yeah.
Some games she and her father can't go to. She puts them up for what they fucking cost.
Fun.
Sometimes what they go for if they were just bought.
Yeah.
But never has tried to fuck people. And she's had the opportunity. Again, I'm just stoked that fucking Comic-Con is being so proactive. Hopefully they'll catch some of these scumbags.
Yeah.
Hopefully some of these tickets will go back on sale.
I just hope it doesn't.
Awesome.
I hope it doesn't, like, the people who got their ticket and then, let's say, like, a month late, you know, a month before, can't, excuse me, legitimately go and put it up for maybe like $50 more, and they see that and get it rid of.
You can't stop that. Yeah. What they're stopping is the people that, if the limited quantity is 3 4-day passes,
and they did under different names and used the same credit card. That's fine. I always fear about the people that legitimately can't go and try and sell it.
No,
you know
that,
what I mean?
That I don't think will be a problem. But again, what's going to be nice moving forward, 6 and 60 leading all the way up, and Comic-Con, as I said, quite a ways away. But 6 and 60 we'll be covering probably every week-ish. I won't say every week,
yeah,
but I will say
it.
Whenever we got something new and important to talk to, and keep stay tuned, I think is the old fucking adage. Stay tuned because we're going to have 6 and 60 coverage. Still figuring out what that entails. Yeah.
Hey, we got a couple months.
Sweet. October 8th through 11th, 2015. If you're going, let us know on our Facebook, our Twitter, or our website, and fucking we'll meet up.
Yeah.
Buy us a beer. They fucking sold like these wonton tacos outside last. Mm. I love some. Be a buddy.
And if you can't fucking make it, there's going to be enough coverage. We got you covered.
Fuck yes, we do.
We got you covered.
So proud of you,
though. Yeah.
The man, the legend, the dead person. B.B. King died at 89 years old.
You're gonna bring that
fucking
up.
Fucking blows. But this guy fucking ruled, man. Is there?
I would have loved to fucking meet him, man.
Do you think there are people that don't know B.B. King?
Definitely.
What type of? I feel like there definitely were.
I think
some
less
young
than
people.
What you would actually realize.
You think enough people fucking like jammed out to fucking Ghetto Woman?
Oh yeah.
Or Shouting the Blues to my fucking.
He was one of my favorites. It's funny because I had a conversation with my mom like a month or so ago about B.B. King. I was like, I can't believe that motherfucker was in the hospital recently. He's 88, and then he got out and he's good. And then a fucking month later, man, I heard he was in hospice, and my mom brought it up to me. She's like, you know, B.B. King's in hospice. I'm like, well, that's it. You know, that's usually what happens. You go to hospice, end game.
It usually doesn't mean that there's fucking a lot of
a lot of hope.
A lot of hope left.
There's definitely very, very sad. A very positive black musician.
Born September 16, 1925, Riley Ben King, who became, of course, B.B. King, was born in
Berkeley?
I'm so bad at fucking words.
Where?
Born in Mississippi.
Oh, okay.
Of course, he did pass away on May 14th. He really revolutionized blues, R&B, electric blues rock. He really was one of these first guys that was like, nah, just fucking make what I want.
Yeah.
And that kind of became his influence, was that it's just, yeah, you can fucking tweak it. You don't need to stay within the confines.
No.
I mean, if you look at this guy, again, vocalist, guitarist, if you're unaware, what I'm going to do is I'm going to definitely at least start the show. I'll probably start into the show with some B.B. King songs so you can actually hear a little bit.
And don't be ashamed that you never heard of him. Definitely
no,
look into him.
This is when you learn about it. BBKing.com is the website. Let's see here. Oh, American Hall of Fame for singing and songwriting. Rolling Stone ranked him at number 6 on its 2011 list of 100 greatest guitarists of all time. In 2003, he was ranked number 3 on the same list, number 17 in Gibson's top 50 guitarists of all time. Just his string bending alone, the like, wow, like that fucking sort
of
like
shit, vibrato and whatnot.
Right there makes him a fucking
king. You know what it was with him when I would listen to him? You could, even with just his playing, like, yeah, singing, you feel something. With his playing, there's not that many musicians anymore that can play an instrument and even play just one note, and that one note makes you feel an emotion.
And you know what I mean? That's the amazing thing about good blues.
Oh, yeah.
Is it like...
I always loved blues, man.
I always considered, like, blues and country try to accomplish the same thing. Never really succeeds with me, but blues always did.
Yeah.
In as much as they're trying to evoke a very specific... I feel this... Now I want you to feel it.
Yeah.
And I mean, he just did such a good job. But again, if you look at these fucking credentials, inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in 1987, of course, considered one of the most influential blues musicians of all time. His nickname, King of the Blues.
Yeah.
fucking, we talk about the king of pop all the time. This fucking king of blues died. And to my knowledge, never diddled any fucking kids.
Allegedly.
He had more than, on average, into his 70s, he appeared at more than 200 concerts a year. That fucking crazy.
Well, there's a venue in New York City called B.B. King's.
Exactly. In 1956, allegedly, he appeared in 342 shows.
That's almost a show a day.
That's fucking amazing. Year. 1990, awarded the National Medal of Arts by George W. Bush. In 2006, the presidential...
See, George W. Bush does care about black people.
Terrible.
God damn
the,
you.
The Medal of... what the hell is it here?
Medal of Honor?
Medal of Freedom. Okay. Damn it. Let's see here. Again, I mean, he was born on a cotton plantation.
Wow.
Isn't that
I didn't know that.
Insane? He considered Indianola, Mississippi, to be his home. When he was 4 years old, his mother left his father for another man, so he was raised by his maternal grandmother in another part of Mississippi.
And he had diabetes, right?
I believe so. Yeah. When he was young, he sang in the gospel choir. He bought his first guitar. Guess how much he paid for it?
$27.
He's 12 years old. He purchased his first guitar, $15.
Wow.
Isn't that fucking crazy?
Holy shit.
Worked as a tractor driver. The guy's unbelievable.
He's a legend.
The story is unreal. Let's see here. 16th Avenue Grill in West Memphis, and later the 10-minute spot on the Memphis radio station, WDI. The radio spot became so popular, it was expanded and became the Sepia Swing Club. This guy alone, fucking his performances, just elevated everything around him. And he's truly going to be missed, man, but what a fucking life. What a life.
Yeah, we bitch about not getting, you know, a certain pop that we wanted and fucking certain collectibles and comics.
That's more you.
And we bitch about, you know, tickets for a fucking con. But look at what that guy accomplished. And he was handed shit in the beginning.
Cotton plantation. Yeah. Rest in peace, sir. You will be sorely missed. On the upside, though, right now they're fucking, you know, they're jamming in fucking heaven.
Yeah. Well, he's showing God how to do an A chord. Meow. It's like, no, like this.
Be like, Jesus, you ever get the blues? Jesus is like, fuck yes. Yeah. Fucking blue shirts, bitch. Have you been watching the playoffs now that your team's been knocked out?
Shut up.
No, I wasn't trying to rub in your face. I was curious. Get this shit.
I didn't watch the last game, but they won.
Get this
against the Capitals,
shit,
right?
Get this shit. So... Second round.
Wait,
of the
did
playoffs.
They win today?
Yes, we did.
Oh.
Second round of the playoffs. The Capitals beat the Islanders in the first round. And then they go on, and the big brothers of the Islanders, who are getting evicted from their home, which those videos were so fucking depressing, of them taking off the ice in Nassau Coliseum.
I started watching some of them.
God.
You know what? I'm kind of pissed that I didn't get one more game. But
so are the Islanders.
No, I'm pissed that I didn't get to go to one more game. But you know what? I went to two. I was there at least once. I'm happy. You know, even Jen. Weird.
Nice.
Yeah.
So get this shit. Rangers Capitals. Mm-hmm. A series that a lot of people were very excited for. Islander fans very much wanted the Capitals to the shit out of us.
Really?
Yeah.
I just want a New York team, man. I'm rooting for the
Islander
fucking Rangers.
Fans wanted told me
well,
many different times to suck a dick.
Well, most Islander fans are fucking are bitter.
They act like Philly fans. The fucking
that's what it. You know what? That's what it is.
Sorry, and
I'm happy for
Philly
the Rangers.
You're a Flyer fan. Fuck you.
A New York team.
Get
I'm fucking
shit.
Happy.
Game one, we lose.
Yeah.
Kind of unceremoniously. Let's be honest. Ovechkin is the great Russian hope. That fucking guy is unbelievable, and I can say that now because of the rest of the story I'm about to tell you. Game two, we get our fucking we get a little bit of revenge.
Yeah.
We win. Game three, they win. Game four, they win.
Ugh.
It's now three games to one. The way that the playoffs work in hockey, very similar to the NBA now, it's a best of seven series. So it's the first team to get to four wins. So the only way that we were able to fucking do it
is to get
was we'd have to win three in a fucking row. The next game out, we come out like a team possessed. We win. The next game, we go into overtime. We win. And then, of course, we come to Thursday's game, I believe. We're playing them, and frankly, it's a fucking war of attrition.
Yeah.
It is a goddamn firefight. Of course, we go into overtime. When it looked like we were completely hopeless, boom, we get it through the fucking creases. Rangers move on. Rangers, Tampa Bay Lightning. Tampa Bay has been talking a lot of shit on the internet. Now, mind you, Ovechkin guaranteed a Game 7 win against the Rangers. So the Tampa Bay Lightning, we're talking a lot of shit.
No.
A lot of people are making up the fact that Henrik Lundqvist, Game 7s in the playoffs, has never lost at home.
Yeah.
Never. But, of course, everyone's like, that's because you guys have to fucking lose the games to get... Fuck your mother. He's still a goddamn miracle worker. And we bring it again today. New York Rangers, Tampa Bay Lightning, game fucking one. We win 2-1 on...
So there's what, eight more games left?
In this particular series, there is six more games.
Okay.
The best of seven. First to get four wins.
No, there's six more. Okay.
And then whichever team wins, Tampa Bay or New York, whatever team moves on. Fucking hockey... I'm always surprised when people get mad at bandwagon fans. It tends to be in the playoffs when everyone becomes a fan of whatever sport's being talked about.
Yeah.
And right now, the sport being talked about, as interesting as basketball has been.
It's like everyone was an LA Kings fan last year.
Exactly right. But this time, it seems like a lot of people are getting ahead of it, and people are just hockey fans all of a sudden.
Yeah.
If you haven't checked out hockey, do yourself a favor, at least watch the highlights from the next game. Depending on when you're listening to it, we either just played or we're about to play. But up to 2 weeks, you know, this series could hypothetically take.
It's 2 hours out of your life. It's the shortest sport.
Fucking sport. It is the best sport. 3 periods, 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Holy fuck, man.
But with everything taken into account, commercials, breaks, it's what? An hour and a half, 2 hours out of your life? And it's the most.
Like
it's so high octane, though. It doesn't start off slow. Has a great middle and then kind of peters out. It's just speed.
It's a lot like soccer, but more exciting because the field is smaller.
Yeah.
They have fucking swords that they're using for their shoes.
And then they beat each other up
and
when they're
fucking. Yeah. If you haven't seen playoff hockey in overtime, the refs pretty much sit down and go to bed.
Yeah.
Like all they're watching for is if someone pulls out a gun.
Yeah.
Because the ass whooping that the fucking Capitals and Rangers laid on each other in these two fucking overtimes in the last two games was unbelievable, Gerard. I thought they were going to kill each other. Now,
I caught Wednesday's game, but I didn't catch the rest.
Do you want a little drama with your sport? I got it for you. Callahan used to be a Ranger.
Okay.
He is now, I believe, the captain of Tampa Bay Lightning.
Okay.
I kept hearing them call Callahan, who was like our superstar a couple seasons ago, and you fucking almost forget. Like, I was like, yay, fuck Callahan. Yeah. We're in our side.
Yeah, but
dude, it is fucking the sport of gods.
Yeah.
Oh, goddamn, I love hockey.
Yeah, but does that, like, with Gretzky, Callahan was a superstar for the fucking Rangers.
I'm only allowed to like Wayne Gretzky because he ended his career in a blue shirt.
Okay.
Otherwise, when people are like, "Great, Wayne Gretzky's the best," I'm like, "He was all right."
Well, with
I have no appreciation of Michael Jordan,
but
he was never a Knick. I'm like, and the Knicks have never been good, so I hate everyone.
But with Gretzky, I have an Oilers jersey. I have.
Yeah, that's because you want to be Kevin Smith, though. It's different.
True. I'm too thin to be Kevin Smith.
That's true.
Well, actually, I don't know. He is caning up on my way.
Yeah, he's fucking. You guys are gonna meet in the middle and then cross. You'll be able to change jerseys.
I don't know. I kind of go. I'm for the team, yes, but if the player is a fucking superstar,
like
you know, I love Lundqvist no matter what.
You're like, you love winners. That's
kind
saying.
Of, yeah. You know, like, what's his name? He actually played Seabass in Dumb and Dumber. He played for the Bruins. I have his jersey. He was from the Bruins. He's retired. He did a lot of fundraisers where... He'd have, like, Dennis Leary and the bass player from Dropkick Murphys. They would play hockey games for his fundraiser. I can't remember his fucking name now.
Terrible story, then.
But anyway, he was a Bruin. Yeah. He's fucking Boston. You know, that's kind of New York's enemy. still own his jersey. You know, I mean, like the player.
That's,
you know,
that's awesome. It's awesome that you. Yeah,
it's awesome, but fuck you.
You're able to cognitively disengage from the ridiculousness that is fandom.
Yeah.
But I am not.
Oh, you're the opposite.
I'm a caveman.
Yeah,
I'm like, if Lundqvist left the Rangers tomorrow, if King Henrik left the Rangers tomorrow, I would never want to fucking hear from him again. Ever.
Really?
Oh,
see, no matter what, though, no matter what, I hate Crosby. He is such a little bitch.
I don't think New York.
Who is
would
it that
him.
Sprayed water in his face?
You are all and, over with your volume.
I'm sorry.
Don't go too quiet now. I'll murder you.
I think it was an Islander. It was Tavares, maybe?
Probably.
That
my favorite Islander move ever.
Did something.
I think he just squirted him in the face with his
water
bottle.
No. It was, I think it was Lundqvist.
Was it?
I think it was a goalie that took his... Yeah, it had to be Lundqvist because the goalies have fucking water
bottles.
That's
pretty fantastic.
I think he took it and just squirted it.
He got in trouble.
He got in trouble for doing
worth
that.
Worth it. Fuck you.
Totally worth. Yeah, he got a $2,000 fine.
Yes.
He got. That's what
worth
it was.
Every penny.
And he said it was totally worth it. He had a statement about it.
He ain't wrong. But go Blue Shirts, baby. Go Blue Shirts. Blue Shirts and five.
I love that what New
that's
York does.
That's my prediction. Blue Shirt
they,
and five,
they
baby.
Light up the Empire State Building when they make
love
a win.
Love it.
That's amazing.
It
that's,
also helps that it's red, white, and
you
blue
because
we're fucking the best.
But when I see it, I don't scream freedom. I scream Rangers.
As you should,
you
sir.
Yeah, I'm just saying.
As you should. Go Blue Shirts.
I want to ask you a bunch of questions, and I want to have them answered immediately.
I hate you so much.
Why?
Okay. Well, there was a four... There was a 40-
Is this one about demonic rape as well?
No, but it's about
okay,
Florida.
Good. Oh, all right.
So that's never a good
not
sign.
Far off.
There was a 48-year-old who flashed his junk in a Target parking lot. His goal, when asked about it, was he wanted to find a lady. So that wasn't super charming. But there's a little bit of competition among the practicing perverts in our declining society, and that competition's name is Alex Chambrello of Wolcott, Connecticut. A local Fox News affiliate reported that the 23-year-old went on a rampage, which included setting houses ablaze and destroying cars like he was in the middle of Grand Theft Auto in a residential area. He did all of this to find his new wife. WAP.
Okay.
Next wife is how he actually worded it. I don't feel like that's the best way to get girls' attention. But as we've learned from my life, I have no fucking clue.
Just try anything that'll stick, I guess.
Being I was right there, I pulled into the complex, and sure enough, there was a gentleman there who we later arrested. Police Chief Edward Stevens told local news. His pants were down, his exposed buttocks covered with tattoos, banging on doors. That was his whole strategy. He would set the house on fire, been naked, knocking a door, trying to find his next wife. Fucking guy covered in like Yakuza style tattoos. This
knocking
fucking...
on doors naked.
Correct.
Setting houses on fire, stealing cars, but knocking first.
Correct. Not only is he facing arson charges, he has a cruelty to animals charge because a cat died in one of the house fires. I think he's going to be okay because when he gets to jail, I feel like a guy who's really comfortable exposing his buttocks and being covered in tattoos is going to be real popular amongst the fellas. Real popular. I think it's now a statistic in this country. The lighter your skin plus the amount of tattoos you have equals the likelihood of a giant brown person raping you half to death in jail. Like, if you go to jail,
if you
were to rob from your job.
I'm raped. And the DSLs don't help either.
They're shaving you down to make you, like, speedy. And they're just going to... You're literally going to be traded for, like, puddings. How does that
They're
going to
call
feel?
Me Flounder.
If Jen didn't exist and you were as crushingly lonely as me, what obscene thing would you do to try to attract women? Lighthouse on fire, expose your buttocks, show your dick off the target. What would be your version?
I feel
I'd
I'd go into a JCPenney.
Okay, perfect. So good start.
Try on dresses.
Excellent. I like it.
But be naked the whole time.
Okay.
But so not wearing like underwear.
Gotcha.
So I put on the dress.
Sense. Yeah, like a sundress.
And then I'd go to the cashier and pay for the dress I'd be wearing. Then I'd rip it off and start punching the cashier in the face.
Ah.
And then begging
for
money.
Is the cashier who you're trying to, like...
No.
You just want other people to see.
Yeah.
Like, what a fucking man.
Yeah.
One, he's cool with wearing dresses.
Right.
It means he's sensitive.
And he's naked, so
two,
he's comfortable in his own skin.
He's strong. He tore his own dress.
Yeah.
Three, he's comfortable
but
in his own
skin. But the cashiers
I have to
punch in the face are little tweens. It's like a summer job for them.
Went without saying. Duh.
They're weakest. They're
absolutely
the easiest
weakest.
One. And then when I go to jail, new fish.
New fish, huh?
Yeah.
I like it. I like it. So your whole plan was just to get arrested.
Oh, yeah, to go to jail and get fucked up the ass. Oh, absolutely.
Huh.
Yeah.
Interesting. What would your attack strategy be if someone was about to rape you? I would just try to chase them.
Attack?
I'd whip out my dick.
Strategy?
And I would just try to, like,
why?
Chase them in a circle.
Why
like,
fight it?
I'm not going to fuck you. I
want it. So just let it be.
That went real weird.
Why attack strategy? Maybe I try and attack them with my dick. Maybe.
Would you, like, flirt? Would you be like, I know this is gonna happen, so we try to find the one I'm most attracted to.
Yeah,
like it winds up.
I'd
being
find
that, like
the strongest guy and call him Thunder, holding his hand everywhere we walk. Yeah, where we going, Thunder? It'd be like a really weird, creepy orange is the new black
again?
For me. I would grow it long again, and then I would get a cornrowed.
Huh?
To look like Bo Derek, you know? I want to look like a dainty tough guy, but not so tough.
Dainty tough guy. How long into your rapey relationship before you're like, okay, it's my turn now, right? Like, would that ever happen? Would you ever get fed up with it?
No, never. Fed up with it. Sounds like the life. Getting fucked up the ass. Getting meals 3 times a day. Getting an hour of gym time. Come on. Why not? And getting fucked up the ass. Why not?
I don't think you realize how not sarcastic you sound.
Jail
you sound
sounds
like,
really
sounds
good right now.
Amazing. Right like- now? The fuck's going on? That you're like, life is too tough. I'd rather be raped in prison.
I'd rather get raped in prison right now.
Huh. That is odd. And I'm troubled.
You were not expecting all those answers, were you?
I am now very worried about you. And
I have the DSLs. So you know I'm just going to get the cream of the crop good-looking
when
jail guys. The ones with the baby blues, you know?
Oh, like that fucking guy who was almost a model?
That's my dream jail, man.
No, you
Jailhouse Rock, more like Jailhouse Cock. Am I right?
Wow. Are you drunk right now?
No.
You're in such a weird mood.
I am in a weird mood.
I like it. It beats the fucking emo rabbit. I like that emo rabbit.
I don't
want to
get fucked
up. Emo rabbit doesn't like anything. Happy rabbit loves everything. Oh, yeah.
I love even the worst.
Fuck it.
I mean, I'm there.
Fuck me, am I right, guys? Everyone here?
Fuck like, my life. Shaking. We're like, fuck my ass. Am I right?
Oh, no. Oh, God. There is something wrong with your brain.
I wonder, what race would I go with, though? Would I be like the white boy that gets beat around by the Chicanos?
I guess it depends where you go to jail.
I think I would. I think that like the Asian gangs, I would go for.
A little dicks.
Yeah, you know.
Smart.
Like I'd still be getting pleasure, you know, but not like, not like shit blood
you don't want
pleasure.
Stitches, yeah.
I don't want shit blood pleasure.
This
and then
I
feel like the white people just, nah.
White people.
Yeah, they'd just be too hate filled. You know, the Aryan Brotherhoods and the, no. They listen to too much, like, skinhead music. No.
I mean, I don't think they listen to
I'm also music. Trying to prove that I'm not a racist, you know? Like, that
smart.
I'm, an, like, my asshole's, like, an equal opportunity.
Butthole.
Yeah.
It's like all the colors of Benetton.
Oh, yeah,
welcome.
Except white. Like, I don't want white.
So, it's you're still a little racist.
Does it count, though, against my own?
Yeah. It's called an Uncle Tom.
Called an Uncle Tom?
Yeah.
I never heard of that.
Yeah, it's when black people were, like, cool with being held down. Or, like, it used to be an insult that black people would say to black people who were, like,
oh, you're an
cool
Uncle Tom?
With, yeah.
I never knew that.
Yeah, I don't know where it derives
from. That's
really
from.
Weird.
That sounds like a white thing. That sounds like another racist white thing.
I think that's why. I think it was, like, oh, what is your name, Tom? Like, I honestly don't know. I'm, like,
okay.
Showing how
the moral of the story is I'm okay with going to jail and getting fucked up the ass by Asian gangs.
But I'm pumping up, I've never, dude, it was the white frothy spit on the side of your mouth. That was just like, this boy.
Oh, is
excited.
That the man, like the old man crust? Oh, I hate that. I'm always self-conscious about that. Like, I always worry
You've
if I'm going to get that or not. Because Jen makes fun of it all the time. She's like, look at that old guy with the crusty spit. in his lips, and we we always make fun of it. But I'm always worried that when I'm talking a lot, I'm going to get it.
You did.
And I did get it.
It was just
son
based
of a bitch.
On being excited.
Son of a bitch.
And, like, it boiled. It, like, it looked like, again, it was like beer foam. It was like all a foam party. Have you ever been to a foam party?
When I was in Fire Island, shut up. When I was in Fire Island, we passed by a bar that there was a foam party.
You're gonna
and
see a dick.
I was drunk, like really drunk, and was shouting out,
so
I want to go to the jizz party. And I just kept shouting that. Till a really friendly officer walked over and said, look, I know you're having a good time. Just calm down. Like, the cops are so different there. Because they can't, they have to run after you. It's not like they can get in a car or they ride like a fucking.
They're super friendly. And also, there's a lot of old people just fucking gobbling cock there. So you see some shit.
This is true.
Like, Vietnam vets, Fire Island cops. Two toughest son of bitches.
Well, I wasn't in Cherry Grove. That apparently is the gay part.
Oh, it's
of,
all gay.
No, the part I Ocean Beach. It's not that bad.
It's all gay.
Whatever. It's a tiny island. I may or may not have had a dick in my mouth.
It's a tiny island and you loved it.
But yeah, I've never been to a phone party. I passed by a place that had a fun No. Why are they fun?
Why aren't they fun?
Well, they play the music and then
yeah, but
foam everywhere.
Covered in foam, which is a liquid. So all the girls are in like fucking see-through shirts.
I would like
you
to watch, but not
them.
Like be in there. I'm not into that. See, you'll drink, have so much fun that you like that stuff, and I'm not knocking it. I can't.
You're knocking it a little, but
I'm awkward. I can't find enjoyment out of it.
What if it was a Majora Mask phone party? The sink.
Da 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 da.
Oh, man.
I
no,
can't,
those things are fun.
I don't find fun. I don't know. Just too awkward for me.
I feel like that's what it is. You never got drunk enough that you weren't awkward?
I'm to enjoy those situations. I'm pretty enjoyable when I'm drunk. Even when I'm not drunk, I am pretty awesome.
All those parties, I mean, that's arguable. Those parties I've been to, it always started out the same way. Charlie, do you want to go to this this whiteout party? Do you want to go to this colors party? Not colored, colors party. Do you want to go to this toga party? It all starts off me being like, I don't wanna do that. And they're like, okay, we don't have to. Let's have 6 to 43 drinks real quick.
Yeah.
And then on that 43rd drink, I'm just like, we're about to foam party. Let's go foam party.
Yeah.
Until you fucked a girl
I've never
in
been
soap. You haven't lived. That's all foam is, I think. Like soap.
It's all jizz, sir.
It's not all jizz, only
it's
the
frothed,
Fire Island one.
It's frothed. Light
I like that you said the word right and then said it again and ruined it.
It's frothed horse cum is what it is.
Is that what it tasted like to you?
Yeah,
just, as you were passing, you were like,
of course.
That's like.
And then I went to I went to a bar and ordered a fishbowl, which was just alcohol.
Fishbowls are the best.
I had two of them.
Is there anything better than a fishbowl?
Because I wanted a second fishbowl.
What about...
And rocket fuel. Oh, my God.
Fucking my buddy Karen had... we always have a pre...
My pal Karen.
We always have a pre-birthday party for my buddy Wayne.
Yeah.
Karen's dating Wayne. One of these, she was like, I'm going to make fish bowls. She got us our own fish bowls. And made what can only be described as the greatest drink of all time. When I say that we got fucked up,
yeah,
it's an understatement.
Ooh,
like, the fact that no one wound up pregnant is a miracle.
Wayne's pregnant with your child.
Yeah, that would have been possible. It would have been possible based on how fucking gross that party was. And it wasn't like there was no one there. It was just a bunch of losers drinking too much.
Was it just you, Wayne, Karen, and like someone else, and that's it?
Oh, there's probably 10 of us.
Oh, that sounds like fun.
Because we had 8 fish bowls, and not everyone got a fish bowl. Some people were just having it like out of a cup, and we mocked them. But it was like nerds as the gravel and Swedish fish. But we didn't eat the candy. We just kept refilling the bowl.
Yeah.
So it literally wound up.
But you get the sugar from the candy.
The fucking Swedish fish broke down to its like chemical solution. It was like this white and gray, horrifically. Dude, it was fucking gross.
Oh,
it looked
man.
It looked like a fish skeleton. That's how much. Because dude, it wasn't like 2 hours. It wasn't 3 hours.
It was like probably like 8 hours.
It was fucking all goddamn day. So we're sun drunk and drunk. Oh,
did you ever, you've had gummy bears soaked in an alcohol, right?
Yes.
Again, you know how they blow up like 4 times their size? I've always wanted to buy one of those ginormous single gummy bears that they sell. It's like maybe the size of a pop figure.
Oh,
actually. And I want to do, yeah, it's bigger. I want to.
They're like 6 inches.
About, yeah. And I want to put that and soak that in alcohol. And I'll probably get like a life-size fucking teddy bear
I imagine you probably have to puncture it.
Oh, absolutely. Otherwise, it won't soak.
That? Let's do that. You're coming to Wayne's pre-party party this year, right?
You
never come.
I don't. I'm never invited, actually.
You're always invited.
I was invited to the barbecue.
That's what it is.
And I went to it. I went to the barbecue this year.
Last year, but not the year before. The year before you didn't come.
Yeah, the last
year. You never
bring
Jen.
Yeah, yeah. I went this past year without Jen.
And Fishbowl. All
right.
Yes, please.
I'm fine. I'll do it. It's in August, right?
You're going to show up.
We're making plans on the podcast.
You're
going to
show up. Jen's going to be there already, and there's going to be foam in the backyard. Oh, you're like, damn it, no!
It's just you and Jen dancing, not on each other, just opposite
sides,
totally like having a dance off in foam. Like,
holy
who can
shit.
Fist pump the
everyone's around us in a circle. Let me clear my throat.
But there's no music. It's just everyone else going.
Or we're singing. Jen and I are battle
acapella.
I think we're delirious.
Oh,
we're punching.
Oh, my God.
Phone parties.
Steak and eggs and eggs and steak.
That's what I had for breakfast.
Phone party.
Phone party. What if you had to throw a big party right now, what would the theme be?
The theme? Fuck. Jungle.
Jungle theme?
Yeah.
My theme would be sucking my nuts.
Please hang up and try again.
But nail and paling.
No more nailing bailing.
Fine.
I got something close to it.
Ooh.
Worcester, Massachusetts. We're moving.
No, it's Worcestershire.
What?
Like the sauce.
I hate you so
Worcestershire.
Much.
Worcestershire sauce.
A superior court sentenced the part-time sex ed teacher to 2.5 years in the straight prison. Guess what her crime was? It was blowing a student and sending him naked pictures.
Hooray!
According to the Worcester Telegram and Gazette, 28-year-old fine as hell Rachel Gendron has been charged with enticing a 14-year-old student into coming over to her place of residence and engaging in sexual acts. The incident was said to have occurred back in 2012, and in addition to performing fellatio on the student, the teacher also sexted several naked photos. The reason for the misconduct on the teacher's part was because the student came to her and he said he felt lonely and couldn't confide in anyone.
This kid's
pickup game is fucking on pizzoint. I wanted to help him, she said. I deeply regret everything that occurred. North Central.
You regret it because you got caught, bitch.
North Central Essential Charter School fired her as soon as the accusations were made back in 2013. On Friday, Judge Janet Keaton Walker, included in addition to prison time that she had to register as a sex offender for sex offender counseling, as well as a mental health evaluation. She admitted to the court that she had been on medication and was suffering from depression and anxiety. She also has a GPS service strapped to her body until it's time to go to prison. In other news, back in January, 32-year-old Oklahoma teacher banged one of her students several times in the teacher's lounge. I had a considerable amount of sex in high school.
Mm-hmm.
Not this much.
No.
If I just knew one slutty teacher.
I don't know what it's about. Like, it's only been till recently that all... It's just always... Every other fucking week, there's something about a teacher blowing, what? And it's always these hot ones.
So this 32-year-old fucking hottie
that
I'm showing you a picture of, she's the 32-year-old who also sex education teacher at a high school. She's confessed to banging students several times in the teacher's lounge. DeRessa Poe spoke with the school administration and authorities on Tuesday about the supposedly month-long intimate relationship she had with an 18-year-old. Poe had also banged earlier that afternoon inside the cab of the unnamed student's truck. As Gawker pointed out, banging anyone under the age of 21 in the state of Oklahoma is considered illegal. Poe feels like shit about everything. I've had sexual intercourse with a student. She confessed in an affidavit, I'm very sorry for the decisions I've made. I would take it back in a heartbeat if the chance was given to me. I'd also wipe it off my back if I remembered. Poe is now facing charges related to sexual battery and second-degree rape. I don't know if I think that's rape. Where's the rape line for you? I'm glad you laughed at one of my jokes.
When the person says, no, I don't want to do this. But what fucking little boy in high school is going to say, oh, no, don't touch my penis. It doesn't feel good. Boy.
I hate to be this. What the fuck?
He's Jewish.
Fair enough. I feel like after 16, I'm not sure if I think it's rape.
I think 16 is the cutoff, to be honest.
We need another
like,
word
not
for
that
it.
I'm saying I'm going to go banging 16-year-old girls. Like, sorry, I'm not, but...
Your fiance already looks 16.
Yeah, it's fine.
Dude, she looks half her age.
I know.
Jen
it's
looks
fucking
half her
fantastic.
Age.
It really is. Like, every time
you
I look
enjoy
at
enjoy fucking someone who looks 15.
No. Well, half her age is... Oh, she'd be 15. Fuck. Damn it. I thought I was going to, like, find a loophole. No, she'd be 18. Nope, she'd be 15.
Womp, womp.
Womp, womp, womp. So funny, I have a whole shitload of reports of teachers banging their students, too.
That was a pretty good segue if you wanted to.
I'm just saying. I'm not going to go into it. I just felt like making that general statement.
Oh, well then, terrific.
So there is a report.
I already read that one.
The
one in your hand?
Damn it.
All right. Moving right along.
Well, I have another one with a whole list of fucking teachers.
Go.
Like, well, basically, there's a report with a fucking... There's a state with the most fucking teachers that bang their fucking students. Do you know what state?
California.
One more guess. You can think more south, dirty redneck.
North Carolina.
The state of Alabama is far above everyone else.
How much above?
It doesn't say. It's just they say they're beyond everyone else.
Excellent.
Done. Anyway, hot for teacher. Sussex County
was
Elementary
that the name
School.
Of the article, or were you
no.
just saying it?
I wrote hot for teacher.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
Let me see.
I wrote hot for teacher.
You're the gayest.
I know. That's how I remember what this fucking. I'm like, oh, okay, that was about all the fucking Saxons. So
a
Sussex County elementary school teacher, Lindsay...
Elementary school?
Lindsay Mazzaro, 26,
taught
8th grade students. She was accused of having sex with a 15-year-old boy in her car and then in her bedroom after the victim's father reported it to the authorities.
Because he was jealous.
Exactly.
He's like, hey, you're supposed to fuck me!
Lisa Glide was sentenced to 5 years probation and faced up to a year in prison. She said she had sexual intercourse with a 17-and-a-half-year-old boy twice.
Why'd they mention the half?
Because he was that much closer to fucking 18 to make them feel better? I don't know.
Touché.
Arrested on the final day of school, Hope Jacoby was taken in for having a sexual relationship with a boy between 14 and 17 years old. This was confirmed once a picture of her was found on the male student's cell phone.
Hot.
The 23-year-old physical trainer at Tustin High School went free on bail, but was tried for oral copulation with a minor and unlawful sex with a minor. So basically, she was blowing this dude.
Awesome.
And it was on the last day of school. Like, that's awesome. Like, all the kids normally... play pranks on their fucking teachers on the last day of school. She was just blowing all every fucking kid. Like, the prank's on you! I love cum. Underage cum.
Aw, boo-hoo.
Pamela Rogers Turner was 27 and an elementary school teacher / coach when she was arrested in February 2005 for having an ongoing relationship with a 13-year-old student. Most people on the list got a slap on the wrist, but Stephanie Raguso, a Florida teacher, of course, was convicted of having sex with two of her students. She was sentenced to 10 years in prison.
Uh-huh.
Raguso was a math teacher in Tampa and pleaded guilty
she taught more than math, son.
to 3 counts of lewd and battery of a 14-year-old boy and 2 counts of unlawful sex with a 16-year-old male student. Again, I
bang,
think...
Bang, 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 bang!
I think 16's okay.
You know what the problem,
that's half
though,
of my list right now.
That kid's shoulder is really injured from all the high fives he has to give in the hallways. Like, that's a lot of chest bumps.
That really
that's
is.
A lot. Though. What would you tell your friends if you had to confess? You're in high school, you're 16... And you're banging your hot social studies teacher.
I don't know what to do, guys. It's just... She just nobbles my knob. so well.
You went with Knobbles My Knob?
Yeah. Knobbles My Knob.
Now, I've never heard the expression Knobbles My Knob.
Yeah, being funny about it. She Knobbles My Knob.
Who?
To my friends. She Knobbles My Knob. No, you banging that pussy? No. Knobbles My Knob.
Knobbling my knob knob. Oh, fuck. What do you think your friends would have said back in the day? Would they be like, you have to report this?
No!
Like, yeah, I have to report this to my diary.
No!
My dream
You're telling
journal.
Your friends you're banging the fucking teacher.
You're asking for them to rat you out. I would never tell.
I guess it depends. No, this is true.
That's the equivalent of
actually, no, I wouldn't tell them because then they would try and fucking get with my piece.
Absolutely.
No, not with her, with my dick. Because if it's good enough for the teacher to if it's good enough for the teacher to bang, what do I got going on there? They just got to take it out for a
then
test
next
drive.
Thing you know, you're in the gym showers, and then it rhymes with grape. Just say novel over time.
Knobbles My Knob.
No, say it excited.
Knobbles My Knob.
Say it like a German.
Zing heiß Knobbles My Schnobs.
I hate you.
Or like John Travolta.
Yes, please.
Oh my God. Just Knobbles My... Or no, I'm sorry. Oh my God. He Knobbles My Knob. Oh my God. Gotta change it for him.
Fair enough. Retarded. It for you kids, episode 15 in the books. Again, make sure you show our sponsors some love, Atomic Comics in Shirley, New York. So if you're on Long Island, make sure you check out the store, spend lots of money. Make sure you go to readuscomics.com to check out the future of comic books, and make sure you check back with us right here at 660.net. Again, any questions, comments, concerns, make sure you go ahead and send it right to our email available through our website, and make sure you rate, comment, and subscribe. Even if you hate us, keep us free. Because if we can do it, so the fuck can you. I love you all, and there's nothing you can do about it. Tadas, motherfuckers. Here's some more B.B. King shouting the blues.